Okay, yes, ma'am. This is Mr. Kamau with policeabuse.com. I'm going to take a brief statement from you regarding a police beating involving the Riviera Police Department. Is it Riviera Beach?
Yes, Riviera Beach.
Okay, why don't you tell me what happened?
Okay, this is what he told me. On the 31st, it happened like around 3 o'clock in the morning. He was on a high-speed chase with the police. He said the reason why the police got on the vehicle because they said that the car was stolen. They put those things in the road, I guess, that you ride over and it flat the tires. That's when the car came to a complete stop. They asked him to get out of the vehicle. He got out with his hands up. He said an officer came behind him and tripped him. And when they tripped him, one officer kicked him. And then all of the officers repeatedly kicked him. He said he put his head, in the middle of the pavement. And one came from the other side and kicked him. And they just repeatedly kicked him. So now his right eye, I want to say that his right eye is closed, shut. And he went to the doctor on Monday. They took him off the jailhouse premises, and the doctor said that they have to take the eyeball out, and fix some things with a socket at. But they're gonna send him to the eye doctor first to see if it's something that the eye doctor can do for right now until the surgery takes place.
Okay, let me back up. So let me just go over what you told me, and then I'm gonna give you some thoughts and opinions, okay?
Okay.
All right, so let me make sure I understand the extent of the injuries. You're telling me he was kicked in his eye so hard that his eye is going to have to be removed from the socket and they're going to have surgery to go back in to repair it?
Right, yes.
Okay.
They hit him so hard, so the eyeball is still in. But what I'm saying is, just within the last 2 days, he's able to kind of open the eye. It's got a blood clot in it.
Mm-hmm.
But what the doctor's saying is he has to take the eyeball out and fix some structure work or whatever in the back where the eyeball sits,
mm-hmm.
and then try to put it back in. But it's not a 50-50 chance that he'll be able to have his vision back,
mm-hmm.
or his eye.
Okay. Let me just say this to you. I have another case, and I'm going to find the link to it. It's called the Atlantic City Police Department beating. We had a young man who had his eye pretty much knocked out of the socket in the same way. And the client is, we have an attorney who's representing that client, and I may want to forward this case over to that attorney. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Now let me give you some things that this young man needs to do, and I'm going to actually need to talk to him in order to assist you further, okay?
Okay.
Okay. First thing is, either him, and I know you said his mom was going to be the advocate, whoever, but one of them has to fill out a complaint form through our website so I can get some additional information. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Second thing, I want you to stay on the line. I'm going to call the police department and just try to get some basic information on what he should do in order to get this complaint addressed. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So just stand by for a moment. Yes, ma'am. How would I report a complaint of excessive force? And I'm calling from a work line, which is recorded. But if you can give me some basic information, I need to know who I would go to, if there's a number I can call, if there's someone I need to speak to in internal affairs who can assist me. It's to report a complaint of excessive force.
Okay, would it be on a Riviera Beach police officer?
Yes, it involved several officers after a high-speed pursuit. They kicked a young man in the eye, and he may lose his eye and his sight because of the beating.
Okay, what you have to do first is come to our station and get a complaint form. You have to fill it out and get it notarized. Then bring that form back, and then they will investigate.
Okay, so you have to get a notarized complaint filled out and then take it back to the police department, and then they'll start an investigation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and
if I have any any further questions, just ask whoever you speak with once you come to the police station.
Okay, so when we come in there, they can then give further instructions.
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. And how will I obtain a copy of the police report if I wanted to see what happened?
What you can do is ask records. I believe they close at 5:30 today, but they open Monday through Fridays from 8:30 to 5:30.
Mm-hmm.
Give them the case number, the address, or whatever information they need to obtain that report,
mm-hmm.
and you can get a copy of it.
Okay, perfect. All right, thank you for being professional and courteous. I appreciate it. Take care and have a good weekend.
All right, you too. Thank you.
Uh-huh, bye-bye. Okay, ma'am?
Yes.
The most important thing that I need is the police report so I can see what the police officers are saying to explain their conduct. So if you can get that for me, I can help you further. So the two things I need is one, for the young man to fill out the complaint form or have his mother fill it out if he's unable to. And then the second thing is I need for you to give me more information, or you can make the request yourself for the police report. But one of us needs to make it. We can actually do it for you, but I need someone to fill out the complaint form in order for me to do that.
Okay.
Okay. Let me just ask you a few more questions. Was he treated by a doctor on the night that he was abused?
Yeah, he went to St. Mary's Medical Center that morning, but it was like, it was at 3 o'clock that morning. They didn't take him to St. Mary's until like 9, 10 o'clock that morning.
Okay, well, two things. One, if you don't mind, I want to put this story on the front page of our website so that when we contact the police, they can see what happened. I have his photograph on the screen right now, and I am recording, and I want the chief of police to see this.
Okay.
Okay? And have his mom call me back. And what is the young man's name?
What is his name?
Is it Christopher McMillan?
Yes, his name is Christopher McMillan.
Okay, and do you know how old Christopher is? 28. Okay, and this happened on what date?
This happened on December the 31st at about 3 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, so just a few days ago.
Yeah, this happened just a few days ago.
Okay, all right, we're going to help you. Just do me a favor, get that report to me or call me, and I'll help you guys get the report. But I will need you to fill out a complaint form, and we'll take it from there.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you take care.
You too.
Uh-huh, bye-bye.
Yes, I need to know how to file a complaint against one of your officers.
He's just swinging on me. And he's just fighting me like I've just committed the worst crime, you know? And I'm just fighting, and I'm fighting back, cause so he won't punch me in my face again.
Bailey.
Yes, sir. Can you give me some information on how I could file a complaint against one of your officers?
Why?
Why? Because I'd like to know what I'm getting myself into.
I think you probably already know, don't you? Who are you?
I mean, who do you think I am? I mean, I'm a citizen. What is that? Why aren't you telling me what I just asked you?